Okay, so I showed you these indicator lights. I just drilled a couple of 5/16 or 8 millimeter holes up there for the indicator lights. And you just need to locate them so that they're out of the way of that ribbing underneath. I did have to trim a little bit back here so I could get the nuts tight. But let me get this in place and then we'll hook them up to the solenoids here. Okay, there we go. Got the wires done. I had to change this to different split connectors here. And we've got that one hooked up there, so that should be the solenoids. And then I just have to get the grinder top plugged in here. Yeah, so you have to get behind this wire. And you have to get in the middle of these tubes here. You've got to get that all in the right spot. So there we go. I think we've got a top on there. And then what I'm going to do is just put the back on. I'm not going to screw it all down because I want to be able to pop the top off and check for leaks down here. I'll just leave it as is and we'll check it out here. See if it works. Okay, let's see if this thing works. There's the pump. Now for this first one, I'm not grinding any coffee, so I just have some pre-ground coffee with a double wall filter. Actually though, let's just try running a shot of water first. There we go. Now let's get up here so I can see my two indicator lights. So I'm just going to do a single cup with no pressure. Oh, there we go. There's the brewing indicator. So the brewing one is on. Now at the end, there's the exhaust solenoid. So let's see. We get pressure now. That's the main thing. I'm going to hit the double cup. And there we got the indicator. Let's check the pressure. Now this is the double wall, so I'm not going to get really high pressure, and it's steady. The old pump would kind of oscillate up and down. I think that works. Now what I want to do is I'll open this up and check for leaks inside. That was more pressure than I was getting before. Again, this is the double wall filter, so it doesn't produce really high pressure. And then you can see up here there's your exhaust solenoid. So that's releasing any pressure out of the thermocoil and pump. So I guess that one stays on for a while.